Ondo Finance, a new crypto that was launched and listed on the coin market cap on January 18, 2024. Ondo Coin is now listed on KuCoin, Katio, and Bybit. Even right now, Ondo Crypto is around $200 million in market capitalization, and it's even on the top 5 trending lists. With it being on the trending list, investors are now interested in the Ondo Coin as they ask questions like, "Nay, what is Ondo Crypto? Is this Ondo Crypto a good coin to buy?" In this video, we will be discussing this topic. But before getting into the discussion, please note that I'm not a financial advisor. Anything I say about coins I talk about is based on my research and opinions. So when investing in any coin I recommend, kindly do a little more research to be on the safer side and do not forget to invest wisely. Without much saying, let's get into the discussion. Obviously, Ondo Finance is a newly launched crypto, so there are a lot of things that are not revealed about it yet. But from what I know, Ondo is a project whose mission is to make institutional-grade financial products and services available to everyone. The Ondo team believes that blockchain technology has the potential to improve the infrastructure of access to financial products and services. Ondo is a good project with good utility. This means Ondo is needed in the crypto space despite being launched last week. Ondo is a good coin to buy for the future if you are looking for a safe coin, but please be wise with your investment amount. This crypto is very volatile. At the moment, Ondo is trading at 20 cents with a market capitalization of $250 million and a 24-hour trading volume of $180 million. Before ending this video, let's dive deep into the Ondo coin for those interested. Ondo Finance's initial product was a DeFi protocol built on Ethereum that provides liquidity services between protocols. In V2, it completely shifted its focus to tokenizing real-world assets, RWA. It introduced fund management products that support various underlying assets, such as U.S. government bonds, notes, and U.S. money market funds. Ondo launched a DeFi protocol on Ethereum that provides liquidity services between protocols, also known as LAS, liquidity as a service. After Compound introduced liquidity mining in October 2020, the market entered DeFi summer, where many protocols used liquidity mining to bootstrap their projects by offering high mining rewards to attract users. However, as more and more protocols introduced liquidity mining, low APY incentives were no longer sufficient to attract capital and users to provide liquidity to the protocols. To compete for users, protocols chose to bear high costs to attract users to their projects at the beginning by offering extremely high APYs. However, such high APYs are not sustainable. To solve this problem, since September 2021, protocols like Ondo Finance that provide sustainable liquidity services for other protocols have gradually emerged in the market. Ondo Finance initially focused on providing short-term, low-cost liquidity to projects. However, with the prolonged bear market in the cryptocurrency space, TVL, total value locked, in the DeFi space has significantly shrunk. The market's attention has shifted to the vast world of real-world assets, aiming to transfer off-chain assets to on-chain assets and opening up the narrative of RWA. DeFi blue-chip protocols like MakerDAO have already introduced RWA-related businesses. Ondo Finance has also shifted its business focus to version 2 and now specializes in the public bond market. This article will provide a detailed explanation of the operation mechanism of Ondo Finance's latest products, OUSG and OMMF, as well as analyze the project's economic model and development status. Ondo Finance introduction. The founders of Ondo Finance are two former Goldman Sachs employees. The project completed a $4 million seed funding round in August 2021, led by Pantera Capital. In April 2022, it completed a $20 million series of funding round, bringing the total funding received to $24 million to date. Ondo Finance is currently focusing on real-world assets, RWA, and has launched funds that support a variety of underlying assets, including U.S. government bonds, bills, and money market funds. This offers investors a diversified selection based on their risk appetite. Ondo Finance charges an annual management fee of 0.15%. The project was founded in 2021 by Pinkas Surana, formerly the vice president of the tech team at Goldman Sachs, who led their blockchain development team. Team members have rich backgrounds from various institutions and protocols, such as Goldman Sachs, Fortress, Bridgewater, and MakerDAO. The organizational structure of the project team follows a standard fund structure, including limited partners and general partners, as well as qualified custodians, fund administrators, and vault auditors. among other third-party service providers. Product development. Ondo Finance was officially launched in August 2021. Its initial version, V1, primarily offered two products, Ondo Vault and DAO Vault. Ondo Vaults are designed to provide users with fixed and variable returns, while DAO Vaults facilitate token liquidity between different DAOs, decentralized autonomous organizations. Essentially, both are tools for capital management. In the first 6 months after its launch, the project's flagship product was the Ondo Vault. A specific number of vaults would be made available for subscription every month. However, 6 months after going live, Ondo developed its DAO Vault product, aimed at providing liquidity services between different protocols. This led to a decrease in the frequency of opening new Ondo Vaults. With the compression of DeFi yields in 2022, the Ondo Finance team decided to phase out Vaults and LOS, collectively called Ondo V1. It introduced Ondo V2, which includes tokenized funds, Ondo Funds, and Flux Finance. It was launched in January 2023. The core feature of Ondo Funds is that it allows stable coin holders to invest in bonds and U.S. government bonds. Investors will receive tokenized fund shares that can be transferred on-chain, including the U.S. Government Bond Fund, OUSG, the Short-Term Investment Grade Bond Fund, OSDB, and the High Yield Corporate Bond Fund, OHYG. Ondo Finance charges a management fee of 0.15% per year. In August of this year, Ondo Finance officially launched the USD Yield, USDY, a tokenized note backed by short-term U.S. government bonds and bank demand deposits. U.S. users and institutions cannot use USDY, and it can be transferred on-chain after 40 to 50 days of purchase. Ondo previously launched four fund products for U.S. users supported by different underlying assets. Among them, the largest and most prominently displayed on the official website is the OUSG Fund. To expand the use case of OUSG, Ondo developed its own decentralized lending protocol, Flux Finance. In February, it announced its launch on the Ethereum mainnet. Borrowers can use OUSG as collateral, and lenders provide stable coins such as USDC to earn interest. Currently, the total value locked, TVL, in Flux Finance's liquidity pools has exceeded $60 million, with OUSG contributing approximately $37 million. The outstanding loans in the protocol amount to about $25 million. Risk warning. The real-world assets, RWA, sector holds significant potential this year, with numerous on-chain and off-chain projects already positioning themselves in the space. Ondo Finance has rolled out tokenized public debt products, allowing stable coin holders to invest in U.S. Treasury bonds and investment-grade corporate bonds through their tokenized funds. However, it's worth noting that this sector still carries the following risks. Connecting real-world assets to the blockchain necessitates dealing with a myriad of legal and regulatory issues. The cryptocurrency industry is still in its nascent to early growth stages, and there is not yet comprehensive legal clarity on the valuation and regulation of cryptocurrencies.